And now we will continue with our next speaker, Denise Duve from DLT Talents. And she will explain the initiative and how she gets women involved in the blockchain space.
Cool. Thank you very much. And welcome to the DLT Talents presentation. We did it, the story of bringing hundreds of women into blockchain. So my name is Denise Duve, and I have the honor to present the DLT Talents initiative today. So first of all, I would like to take the chance to say thank you. To say thank you to Philip and Michael, both fathers of girls who had the initial idea for the program. And then they put together this amazing team that together designed the program and keep it the successful initiative it is. I would also like to say thank you to our partners, which you can see on the right-hand side of the slide, because we are offering this program free of charge, and that is only possible due to them. And thanks, of course, to the Frankfurt School Blockchain Center, which is making all this possible in the first place. So what is the DLT Talents Program? The DLT Talents Program is an 18-week program designed to coach and sustainably support female leaders who want to pursue a career in the blockchain ecosystem. Why do we do that? Blockchain is 95% male, and that has to change. That has to change not just from my perspective as a woman, but from an overall perspective as well. Because I do not need to convince anyone here that blockchain is one of the technologies which is quickly gaining momentum and will play a major role in all kinds of infrastructures and eventually in our daily lives, especially with other technologies like AI. So onboarding women into that field is key, not just in order to create equitability for the opportunities of the future, but also to maximize the economic results overall. Because the diverse teams are proven to create better results. So women should become part of the shaping process, driving this great technology so that it can live up to its real potential. And the lack of female talent is not the issue here. I'm just saying that because some may say, well, women are just not that interested in the field. They do have other strengths, or even they are just not as good in coding or programming or stuff like that. However, the lack of women in technology leadership is part of a more complex story, which is severe. Just to give you another jaw-dropping fact, in the information technology industry, 17.9% of board directors are female, and the gap rises looking at CEO level, where only 3% are female. So this situation is the result of a more complex story. Let me just point out STEM education and women in risk taking. In STEM, there are stereotypes that certain subjects are more suitable for one gender or the other. While STEM are usually categorized as male subjects, and more boys are actually choosing STEM classes, e.g. here in Europe or most Western countries. But looking towards the UAE, 85% of STEM graduates are female. And without discussing this in more detail, everyone can at least agree that there seems to be a cultural component here. And risk-taking. Reshma Sayani, the founder of the very successful Girls Who Code initiative, elaborated in her book, Brave, Not Perfect, that most girls are taught to be perfect from young age on. They are not taught to embrace risk and fail and get up again like most boys are. However, exactly these behaviors are highly rewarded in our current work environment and are needed to get into a leadership career or to make a riskier but more rewarding career change. So these are just some examples how underlying cultural topics are creating obstacles for women. However, if women are not going for those jobs early on, they end up in a male monoculture, making the barriers to enter even higher, and potentially are creating a toxic environment, as we learned from the Silicon Valley story. So it will be getting more and more difficult to change this, with a lack of role models to look up to for the next generation of women, and a lack of open mindset in these monocultures to fight against unconscious bias. So barriers due to unconscious bias. Let me give you one example of unconscious bias just to visualize how present and hindering it is. People always say you just need to be bold to succeed. But again, that is definitely not the whole story. You also always need someone that believes in you. You need that supportive network and people giving you a chance. So guess what? Not always that easy as a woman. So for example, if you want to found a startup, at some point you're going to need funding. So you go in there in a pitch situation as a woman. And as a woman, you ask very defensive questions, preventive ones. While if you go in there as a man, you are asked more growth-oriented, promotional questions. So in simple terms, if you go in there as a woman, people are mainly concerned about how you're not going to lose the money invested. And if you go in there as a man, you are asked promotional questions, so how you grow the business or generate a return on investment. So guess who? Just by this line of questioning, we'll get more funding after all being equal. Yes, there's twice as much funding for entrepreneurs who were asked promotional questions, so the return on investment ones. And the severity of this issue is underlined by the World Economic Forum, which found that the gender financing gap to be one of the most persisting problems when it comes to entrepreneurship. So breaking this vicious cycle is our goal as DLT Talents, cutting through the challenges created through bias, stereotypes, and monoculture. And turns out, a bootcamp based on simple leadership career 101 does the trick. Role models, network, structured learning. So we designed a platform providing exactly that. And then we select this incredible talent worldwide, and we are giving them first a boost on the role model front. Because there are some awesome ladies out there already part of the shaping process of this industry. And we are making them more visible, and we are giving access to them. Showing female talents that it can be done, which creates a boost to motivation and aspiration on a wider front. Second, a boost on the solid network creation front. Women are often not as integrated in networks, but a supportive network is crucial for a successful career, as everybody knows. So we encourage the talents to mingle not just with these great mentors, but among themselves, by giving them the tools, the reason, and the setting to do that. And structured learning guidance. So of course you need to know your stuff. So we are providing a kickstart to enter the new field through a structured approach. Guide them in a bootcamp-like manner through what is important to learn. And therefore, we designed this three phases approach. And in the first phase, we get the participants up to speed with the basic concepts. In the second phase, it's all about getting to know the different domains. So entrepreneurship, technologist, regulator, influencer, investor. So the areas they eventually pursue a career in. And in the third phase, it is for them to focus on one domain. They will develop a deeper knowledge during that phase and advance from generalists to specialists. But how does that look in practice? So throughout all phases and sessions, we are giving the DLT talents assignments beforehand. As we want them to participate, we do not want to lecture them. We want them to get hands-on and take on all kinds of challenges and approach all kinds of topics. And then we meet in these bi-weekly Zoom sessions. And there the talents have the opportunity to present and discuss their work in smaller groups, in breakout rooms. And in the end of each session, we have always one inspiring keynote from one of our amazing mentors. And the participants have the opportunity to ask questions, profiting from their experience and the knowledge of those great women. So we are giving them access not just to one great role model, but several ones that can accommodate all kinds of individual endeavors. And it's actually amazing to see what is happening when you put an ambitious group of people in one room, all eager to connect and learn from and with each other. It's pure energy. So besides of this session, we are having a lively DLT Talents community to exchange ideas, discuss and organize into subgroups of special interests, plan separate meetings, etc. So you see, the whole structure is set up for the talents to get out depending on what they are willing to invest. We just provide the framework and the platform. And our talents are flexible to fit it to their needs and interests. And let me just say, during the short time we are doing this program now, it became incredibly clear how crucial and inspiring those role models are. And it became incredibly clear how important that network between those DLT talents is, as they often share the experience of being the only woman in a work or education setting. And now they have this network of like-minded, talented, and ambitious women, all ready to support and engage instantly as a group when an idea is right. And the DLT talent success story proves us right. It proves how many qualified talents are out there, all ready to pursue a career in blockchain when they are provided with the right platform to get started. So when we started to elaborate on this program, we would not dare to think that we can put together such an amazing group of inspired, talented women of that size. So in our initial call for application, via LinkedIn post, so just via LinkedIn post, we looked for 12 outstanding women who want to take this opportunity to grow with us in this quickly developing field. However, after the application started to fly in, we could not, in good conscience, limit ourselves to 12, with that amount of incredible talented women all wanting to take part. So we chose over 50. Which is great, but still, it was a difficult choice to make. And in the next cohort, so the second cohort, the current one, we got substantially more applications. And now we are having 100 women enrolled in our program from 30 countries. And to give you another fact, 35 got a job in the field immediately after the first batch. And just on a side note, we were wrongfully tagged as a headhunting firm just recently, as we probably create more new entrants into the field than many others. So what do they say? What do the participants say? They say, it was a game changer for me. The network created is invaluable. It was a unique experience. I learned to step out of the comfort zone. I learned to just do it. I have a solid knowledge foundation now. So being here, seeing what we have started with DLT Talents, gives us a very good feeling that the statistics of 95% male will have to change soon. And it is exactly the right time for the blockchain ecosystem now, while the technology is still in its infancy. So we can embrace diversity from the beginning. And that would give it a huge advantage over other rapidly growing technologies with Silicon Valley's toxic masculinity problems ingrained. And we need to break the vicious cycle, as technology is increasingly amplifying the human capital. Hence, missing out on potential is coming at exponentially increasing costs. So, help us do it. So the next call for application will be open soon. If you are interested in becoming a DLT talent, the next cohort starts on October 4th. And if your organization puts a lot of emphasis on inclusion in recent time, please point the responsible decision maker in our direction, as we are a worthwhile cause to support. Thank you.
Yeah, hello. Thanks very much. We decided to basically add a couple of minutes at the end. Denise is project leader with DLT Talents, and it worked extremely well. And I think, Denise, we can say that right now the current batch, which is ongoing, is also working well with very smart people, good discussions, and especially this kind of home assignment mode where we ask the participants to self-reliantly work on specific tasks and then basically present their results 2 weeks after works extremely well. And I think, Denise, we can say that we found really a good mode for pushing people a little bit, for empowering them, but also to help them get acquainted with the technology. And we also see the numbers because we already see that people are getting employed. And if anybody of you are interested in joining this, as Denise has said, go for it. I think it's worth it. And what is also important for us is also getting more sponsors. Everybody is complaining about too few women in tech. Now we are doing something. And for us, it's not easy to find people, for example, sponsoring this entire program. So there is a lot of talking out there, not too much doing. That's why we wanted to change it. And I think we are doing quite well. This is basically proved by the numbers. And therefore, I would also like to basically call out to everybody here listening, in case you know people who could also support us. We would love to have two more sponsors. So far, we have Commerzbank, we have Quantstamp from Singapore. They are doing smart contract auditing. We are also in the closing discussions with KfW from Frankfurt. But it would be great to have two more companies pushing this and also basically being ready to employ female talent in blockchain, which is there. I think, Denise, we know that the talent are there. But with this, I think, I wanted to make this call together with Denise. Maybe at this point of time, we hand back over to Manuel. Would this be okay?
Thank you. Yes.
Yeah. Great. Thank you. Thank you, Philip and Denise, for introducing this great initiative.